Hello friends, once again I welcome you to my channel. Please like, share and subscribe the channel. Today I am going to start a new subject of fifth semester, that is machine design. This is the name of the subject. It comes in fifth semester. Machine design is a fifth semester subject. In this subject, we deal with designing of machine elements or machine parts, parts of a machine. Now, what exactly does it mean? What exactly does this mean? See, a machine, any machine is an assembly of a number of parts or elements. Now, each element has a specific duty, a specific work, a specific function, and if all the parts of a machine are performing their functions correctly, only then the performance of the machine will be correct. Otherwise, it's not going to be correct. Even if a small part is not executing its function, then the machine is going to fail. Now, if we analyze the parts, we find that they are subjected, when they are performing their function, they are subjected to some force, a definite force. Now, we should know the magnitude of that force, and the nature of that force. See, the load, we call it as, what in science they call as force, we call that as load in engineering. Now, this load may be tensile in nature, may be compressive in nature, may be shear in nature. If it is tensile, compressive or shear, we say the element, that particular part, is subjected to direct stress. It may be a compound stress like twisting, bending, bearing, etc. So, these are the types of different types of loads that can act on a part. Now, the part must be able to sustain that load. It must be able to withstand that load. Otherwise, if it is not able to withstand that load, what is going to happen is the part is going to fail or break. What we say break in ordinary language, we call that in engineering as failure. Now, if one part of a machine fails, then the entire machine fails. So, we should see that that doesn't happen. Now, for that, what we have to do is, we have to first find out what is the load that is acting, the magnitude of the load, the nature of the load. Then, what is the material from which that particular part is being made, and what is the permissible stress or bearing pressure or whatever it is, what is that? Then we should find out what dimension we should have for that particular part. It may be diameter, it may be thickness, it may be width, it may be anything. What dimension the part should have so that it sustains, it withstands that particular load. This is what basically design is. Design is basically finding the dimensions of the parts of a machine so that it is able to withstand the load that is likely to come on it when it is performing its designated function. Now, you know, in SOM, strength of materials, in third sem, we have studied the stresses. We have studied simple stresses, and also we have studied torsion and all that. Torsion, bending, theory of bending and all this, you are you have learnt. Now, if it is a direct stress like tensile compression or shear stress, then you know stress is equal to load by area. Now, this stress that we are using here depends upon the material from which the part is made, and this stress is the permissible stress always. The stress within elastic limit, much below the yield point, it should be that stress. Now, that depends upon the material and what type of load we are applying. There are different stresses. If the load is tensile in nature, we have to use the permissible tensile stress. If the load is compressive in nature, the stress must be the permissible compressive stress. If it is shearing load, then it should be shear stress. Now, these are the three types of direct stresses that are going to be there. So, if we know load and the permissible stress, corresponding permissible stress, then we can know what is the area that is required to resist that load without exceeding the stress. Now, if we know the area that is required to resist that load, then we can find out the dimension. Basically, this is what we do in machine design. Now, if it is direct stresses, this is the formula. Stress is equal to load by area. Once we get the area, we can find out the dimension required for that particular element. If it is twisting, then you have to use the general torsion equation. We know that T by J is equal to Fs by R or tau by R is equal to C theta by L or G theta by L. General torsion equation is used if it is twisting. If it is subjected to, the element is subjected to bending, then we use general bending equation, which also we have studied. If it is subjected to bearing action, then we use the bearing equation, that is load is equal to permissible bearing pressure into bearing area. So bearing area will be equal to load divided by permissible bearing stress. Bearing pressure, it is called. It is not called as bearing stress, it is called bearing pressure. Permissible load divided by permissible bearing pressure gives us the bearing area that is required to support the load. So, from that area again you can find out this thing. So, these are the things that we use. Now, the machine design, there are two types of design. One is called the rational design. One type of design is rational design. Rational design means we are going to use a formula, mathematical formula, which is derived from one of these things which is derived, that is called as rational design. Then we have one more type of stress, design called empirical design. Empirical design means here we use sometimes in some places we use what we call empirical formulae. Empirical formula means the design is done by empirical formula. Empirical formula means this formula has no mathematical support. That is, it is not mathematically supported, but it is devised by some engineer, and it has been found by his practical experience. Based on his practical experience, he devises a formula, and it has been time tested, and we have internationally accepted such a formula. Now, for example, when we design a riveted joint, we use a formula dia of rivet. We use a formula 6 root T, where T is the thickness of the plate from which it is used, from which the joint is made. This T is the thickness. Now, this formula is called as the Unwin's formula. Now, this formula is an empirical formula based on somebody's experience. It has been devised and it has been found to be working, and it has been accepted throughout the world as okay. Then we use such formulae then we call that design as empirical design. Now, once a part is designed by empirical formula, what we have to do is we have to check it. We have to check whether with that formula what we are getting some area, and we know the load. This load by area gives us the stress. This stress is within the permissible value or not, and if it is not within the permissible value, then it is likely to fail. So in that case, the area must be increased or the dimension must be increased so that the area increases and this stress comes below the permissible value. So this is called as empirical design. So there are two types of designs which are done normally, and you have to know these things. Now, we hear the syllabus, your syllabus says design of fasteners, in which we study screw fasteners and design of riveted joints, which are permanent fasteners, and screw fasteners are temporary fasteners. So we study the design of screw fasteners and riveted joints. Then we study design of shafts, keys, and design of couplings, shaft couplings, and design of quarter joint, knuckle joint, and springs. So this is your syllabus. Design of screw fasteners, then riveted joints. These both come under fasteners, design of fasteners, then shafts, keys, shaft couplings, quarter joint, knuckle joint, design of knuckle joint, and then we have design of springs, in which we design helical springs. So these are the thing that are there. The syllabus is this. Now, in this subject, you are allowed to use this design data handbook. There are design data handbooks written by different authors. Now, the notation from one design data handbook to other design data handbook, the symbols used vary. Now, you can use any of these prescribed design data handbook, and you are allowed to use it even in the examination, and you have to pick the values, the formula. You need not by heart the formulas. You need not know them by heart. You can pick up the formulas from here and do it. So now you get used to one particular design data handbook, and you become thorough with that notations, so that it doesn't make a difference to you when you are doing the problems in the examination. Now, this paper, about 70-75% will be numericals, only 25-30% will be the theory part. So most of the about 70 marks you can score in numericals. It is a numerical subject, and you can score, if you pay little attention, you can get very high marks in this particular paper. So I am going to take up the mathematical part, the numerical part in this thing. I will start with design of screw fasteners.